Look what we got. Another spindle motor. Somebody sent me an email asking about these that they found. So I bought one to test out a bit. It's a treadmill motor. It's a 1,000 watt. And it's got the brushes going straight in from either side, so it should be reversible. It's not that big. I think it's only 3.5 inches in diameter, so it's smaller than the other treadmill motor I was using. It's less power, 1,000 watts, but still that's better than the stock motor. I'm thinking this could be a good emergency motor. It comes with a little big belt pulley on there you can take off. It comes with a, should be a 14 millimeter shaft, which coincidentally is the same shaft for as the 1100 watt motor. And it comes with its own little controller, runs off a 110 AC to hook up. It gives it 110 DC. I gotta get a pot. Doesn't come with a pot, but you can hook up a 5K pot to control the speed. Speed is supposed to only be 3,900, which is less than the stock mill motor. But you know, like I said, as a easy emergency motor, because total price for motor and controller is $27.50 plus shipping. It's about 12 bucks shipping for me. It's not real heavy. I think it's 9 pounds or something like that. But it's at Skycraft Surplus. Last time I checked, they still had like 160 of them available for $27.50. You cannot beat it. Comes with a base mount, but you can see it's got the bolts. You can easily take it off. I'm going to look at printing out a motor mount to fit with my belt drive. You know, kind of like I did on the other treadmill motor. It'll just grip onto the housing here, maybe here. I'm also going to look at it. It's got two bolts coming all the way through. I'm going to take one of them out, see what the thread is. Maybe you can get a, use all thread or use a longer bolt, have the threads coming through, and then you can just put the plate on and put a nut on the bottom. I think that'd probably be the easiest way to do it, but have to take a bolt out and see what it is. See what McMaster has in stock. It is used. It's got some scratches and dings, but still feels pretty good. But like I said, we gotta wire it up and try it out. Okay, little pulley's off. It's keyed, of course. Came off with a little persuasion, so it's held in with a left-hand thread screw. Take it out and pull it off there, and it does have a 14 millimeter, almost 14 millimeter shaft. Okay, took one of the two bolts that holds the motor together. It's an M6 by 1.0. Verified it with a tap. When it's bolted in, as you can see, it just comes flush. So I want to get one that's longer, so it'll protrude out so I can bolt a plate on to the end of the motor as the motor mount. It'll be a lot easier than making one that has to clamp on. So this is 6. I'm going to have to check with McMaster. This one's 6 7/8 inches long, which is about 171 millimeters. I want to get one that's at least 7 1/4, maybe up to 7 1/2. It's 185, 190 millimeters long. Who knows if they have one that long, we'll see, but if nothing else, I can get all thread and a couple of M6 nuts, and it'll do the same thing. It's this lower end of the motor is threaded, so of course it's thread through. So I figured the bolt stick out, just put a plate on there, tighten it up, we'll have our motor mount. Okay, I kind of got the wiring rigged up to where it'll come on at least. Hard to figure out what wire goes where, but I experimented and at least got it working at full speed apparently. Got a little tech thing on here. There it is. There you go. Max speed is about what it claims, 3900-ish. But the problem is, you see, its normal rotation is opposite of what we need for the mill. He's looking at it like on the mill, it's going in reverse. So I'll swap the motor wires and see how it works in reverse. Okay. Swap the wires around. Just a hair less RPM, but still pretty close to the 3900 it claims. As you can see, it's going in the correct direction for the mill. So if you hook it up, I'm going to try hooking up to my KBMM next. Swap the polarity of the motor wires. Okay, hook this motor up to my KBMM is on the mill. So I can control the speed here. You can get it going pretty slow. I cut myself on that keyway, but so you gotta go in the correct direction. But sounds good. It's going in reverse technically. He's sparking. I got my KBM set max at 100 volts. This stock of the controller that came with this is supposed to put out 110 volts. That's what this motor is rated for, so you can adjust the pot on the KBM to get it up to max RPM, because at 100 volts RPM's down a good bit. But there, motor works. Good little emergency motor. Actually, it would have more power supposedly than the original motor on the mill. Here, I think you can compare it to the 1100 watt. It's not near as big. You can see, compared to the mill, it's not that big a motor. Motor plate off, mount it up there. I'll do that maybe in a few weeks. Gotta change ball screws first. And when I go to try it out, I'll increase the RPM, the max pot on the KBMM to raise the max voltage. I know it goes up to like 120 volts. So we can get the RPM up. But it works for 2750. There you go. Got that motor plate. See? Not a big motor.